I don't even know how to segue from funky to us, Eric.
We'll do what we can.
This is a really great exhibit. We're at the Western Reserve Historical Society. It's now being called the Cleveland History Museum, you guys. But same awesome place. New exhibit, Cleveland starts here. Now, this is a big wall that shows how you guys are using interactive elements, artifacts, history, pretty much everything here, correct?
Yeah, so, you know, we've tried to get as much of the story in Cleveland as we can in a relatively small space, but we also have interactives. You know, these are historical objects that kids can try to guess at what they are.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we have a modern version of what you're looking at today.
Yep, that was the abacus, now it's a calculator.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you should put like a rotary phone. Because I wouldn't know what that
was. Oh, there's that too, sure. Yeah, we're not quite there yet.
No. Right. And then here's what I like. You have some digital elements. You have interactive elements that, so people can actually participate and experiment on how they want to learn about the history of Cleveland.
That's right. And one of the things we really want to happen with this exhibit is these are all things from our collection.
Mm-hmm.
And these are things that, you know, if you find something here that you're really interested in, it's here and you can go see it. You know, so this is this exhibit is really, it's a gateway to the rest of the museum.
Yeah, and the 1870s, 1860s, pretty thematic because you have some events coming up, that would correlate with those, correct?
That's right, yeah. So this is a very large gallery. It's our community space. It's the entrance to the museum. So we could use this for community engagement. And what we have coming up here in 2 weeks is our annual, it's called Somewhere in Time. It's our annual costume party.
Okay.
The theme this year is the 1870s. Satin and soot is what it's called. It's
okay.
The Gilded Age, but there's also some dirt involved.
Okay.
And who doesn't want to come to a costume party in a history museum?
No doubt. That's awesome. The Bulldog Revolver we see here, why is that significant?
Yeah, so that is, it's not the gun that shot James Garfield, but it is the same type of gun. The original gun is currently missing. It's been lost to history, but that is the same type of gun that assassinated James Garfield.
And the bicycle?
That's made by Peerless. Peerless started out in Cleveland making mechanical clothes wringers, clothes dryers.
Okay.
They transitioned to bicycles when bicycles became popular, and then they went to automobiles around the turn of the 20th century.
1920s, Cleveland, fifth largest city in the nation.
That's
that was kind of a heyday for us, right?
Absolutely, yeah. Right. Then that's a direct result of World War I. There was such an influx of people coming into the city to support the war effort in Cleveland that we became the fifth largest city, and that's as big as we ever got.
All right, the Cleveland History Center, a really cool exhibit. Cleveland starts here, about the history of our city.
Wow.
And you can see all of the Wayne Dawson artifacts here.
Oh my gosh. Go ahead.
Wait. I couldn't resist.
Okay. They're right next to yours. You know that. Come on, now. We're in this thing together.
Yeah. The Wayne and Kenny wing. Wayne and Kenny wing. The relics. The yes. Dinosaurs.
Well, maybe Stephanie and I will come visit just to see them.
What are you talking about? You guys will be there in a few years.
I'm there. I'm knocking on the door, my friend.
I'm only kidding. We just like to joke around.
Yes, we do.
You know.